In the spotlight this morning, it is time once again for another international film festival right here in Rhode Island. Movie buffs will be flocking to several screening locations across the state for another series of great entertainment. Here to tell us all about it, George Marshall, Executive Director of Flickr's Rhode Island International Film Festival, along with Program Director Sean Quirk. Good morning, everybody.
Oh, good morning. Good morning.
Nice to have you guys here. First of all, George is walking around scalping tickets.
You betcha.
Good to have you guys here. A lot of people out there may think of independent films or as being small films. It's become so much easier to make a film and a quality film, correct?
Absolutely, and that's because of digital technology. And the nice thing is, it's worldwide. I mean, also the fact people can use their cell phones. People are much more attuned to the medium, and we're finding that we're getting more and more entries actually from across the globe because of this.
Because of this. Sean, talk about this. This is a big deal for the state of Rhode Island, and having a film festival like this, I'm sure you get a ton of entries as well, right?
This year we had over 6,000
entries. Wow!
From as many as 65 countries this year.
So is it hard to narrow down the top, the best of the best for all of these?
It really is. We have judges from all over the world, over 100 judges, and we narrow down these titles. This year we narrowed them down to 270 titles.
And so, a lot of these independent films may start off as independent films, but move on to bigger and bigger.
Absolutely, because what we've discovered is over the years, I mean, we have people that actually have a trajectory with us, that they will start off as students, then they'll go into the industry. And in some cases, their work then goes from a short film to a feature film. And a short film is kind of a calling card in most cases for filmmakers to actually evolve and grow in the discipline.
All right, talk to us about this year's event, because you've got the posters here, you've got a lot of things. It's a bigger event than ever before.
It's also our 20th anniversary.
Which is great.
Which is a huge milestone for us. And the fact that we have Academy Award qualifications, we're the only one in New England with that. We have short film, documentary film, and animation. We're also a BAFTA British Academy qualifier, and now the Canadian Screen Awards.
And a lot of big name stars now want to be part of even these smaller independent films, right? Does it give them more creative
work? Well, we have the world premiere right now of three shorts with notable names. World premiere. Jonathan Pryce, who is the High Sparrow in Game of Thrones.
I love that.
James Brolin, Robert Streisand's husband.
Sure.
And then we also, who's the third one?
Kieran Hines.
Kieran Hines, who is in The Shore, and he's also in Bleed for This, the upcoming film with on Vinnie Passianza that's coming out in November. So that's there. Plus, we have Karen Allen coming here. We're announcing it for the first time. Karen Allen is in a feature film that we're going to be screening here. She will be here Thursday for our Rhode Island Film Forum, receiving a Creative Vision Award.
Really good stuff. Really is. All right, let's go over some of the movies that you guys have. First of all, let's talk about A Beautiful Day.
Sean?
A Beautiful Day stars James Brolin, and we'll be having the world premiere at opening night.
I mean, look at just the quality of these movies. I mean, they really look like big-time movie.
It's a fantastic film, and it's all about just one day of this guy and how he deals. One decision he's made, and we see the consequences of that decision when we see the film. But it's a great film, fantastic, and we hope you guys see it.
Next up, Last Days of Summer.
Oh, Sean? That stars William Fichtner. And this is a world premiere. Yeah.
And you recognize the face.
There is, yeah.
It's a fantastic film. It has elements of both thriller and comedy and drama.
Right.
So the tone shifts very delicately between all three.
Throughout and he's expected to be here.
That's also great. Yep. Next, The Talk.
The Talk is by Alain Delanois. He's from Canada. And it's an animated documentary. And
that is cool looking.
All these subjects talk about that awkward talk about the birds and the bees.
Got it.
So it's a really great film, and there's a lot of dynamic conversations, and we hear from all different types of subjects.
And guys, tickets are still available to
get
this?
Absolutely, and people can buy them online or at the door for all of our events throughout the week.
Good stuff. A lot of fun, and really great for Rhode Island and for everybody who loves film like this. If you want to check out these movies and many more at the Rhode Island International Film Festival, you can head over to roadshow.com for a link to the full schedule of movies.